Good morning and thank you so much for this call today. We're very happy to see you today. Okay, for me, I have a very friendly question for you regarding our assignment. Have you ever given a student this class? Why you did that?
I never heard any class. When I tell the story that's 21 or just when I was younger, I used to have a math teacher, and he used to say A plus is for God, A is for me, you can have B. No, that's not the main thing that I think students tend to not understand is that A plus is quite exceptional. I gave some A, okay, but A plus means that it really needs to be nearly perfect. And perfection is not really part of this work. It's always, we have changed a little bit the way we are grading now to make sure that we are using the full range. And to be frank, I have given more A's in the last 3 years than I wrote in the past.
Thank you. So I think we have to try
our best. Yeah. But, and you know, to be frank, you're going to graduate in 10 years. Are you going to think, oh, I had an A plus? Or I was mad at my teacher because he gave me an A where I was deserving an A plus? Is it really going to make such a difference in your life? I don't really think so. That's another thing about the assignments. Some of the assignments are requiring you to work in groups. Okay? The issue with the regulation that my university is that we are not allowed to grade group work. And that's what students asked a few years ago. We used to do that. So there are some elements where you will need group work, and this group work is going to actually help you build up your analysis of your individual assignment. Make sure the people on your group are at the same pages, that you are at the same, you want to achieve the same thing. And there is no, I'm not judgmental on that, I'm not saying that it's right or wrong. Some students are perfectly fine with a pass. Okay, and they are just happy to do that, and that's fine. Others are saying, no, I want an A, I want to aim for, you know, that. Imagine that you are in a group where you have not discussed that. Of course, the student who is going to say, I want just to pass, is going to work just to pass. And the student who wants an A is going to be completely mad because his work is going to be more affected by the group. So it's something you need to discuss among you at the start to make sure you know you are at the right level. If you are not at the same level, at least you know it. At least you are aware of it, and you can actually compensate, decide to go and work in another group. Decide to work more for some students, and so on and so on.
Thank you so much. Since our grade, this is our first time. And also I want to encourage our new candidates on all this fundamental surviving and other questions. Will be covered by our SDN tutor actually. So don't be too nervous and don't be too anxious about the assignment. We have a very experienced tutor and lecturers. Because I have just finished my first unit, and
Okay. Just to comment on that. We are not psychic, okay? So if we don't know there is a problem, there is nothing we can do for you. So we also need your input. If you have any questions, if you have any things that you don't understand, we won't be able to, you know, I cannot wake up in the morning and say, well, in Myanmar, that's what they need today. That's not possible for me. If I'm receiving an email from you or from someone saying, you know, the students are asking us that, then we can do something because we are aware of it. But if we are not aware, there is nothing we can do. And you know, we are just like, we are in higher education to help. So our aim is that you all have your MBAs or your master in the best condition ever. And we are here to actually help with that. So don't hesitate if you have a question. The easiest way is to go through your tutor that is going to contact the tutor in your wing. If there is some elements that are more, I would say, about the organization and all those kind of things, it's going to Nyo-Nyo or Vicky. So don't hesitate, don't be shy if there is something, you know, you're struggling with.
Alright, so let's go back to my new unit, strategy management, because I am excited. Okay, just now you show one assignment guideline. According to this sample assignment, I just want to know what strategies and analysis of the organization. What are the indicators we can look at in this organization and overlay with the environment method and
That's a really specific question that is more based with the content of what is going to be in your unit. So I can observe there are some frameworks that are really, really specific when you are looking at an external analysis. You will have some tools that are there, tools, frameworks that are there to actually help you analyze, and that's part of the content of the unit. So as I said earlier, PESTEL, five forces, what we call green analysis, you will have some elements about what we call the answer matrix, quantum generic strategies of whatever. And that's always the same when you're starting a unit. What is really difficult at the beginning of a unit for students is to understand the brief, because of course you have not seen already what you are going to need, but you don't know what you need right at the beginning because you have not studied it. So that's why I think that there is a progression about looking at the brief, looking at the first few sessions you're going to have, coming up with question of week 3 for your first assignment and so on and so forth. But don't worry, you will have the content for it. So do you feel for the new student, do you feel confident? for the returning student, do you feel confident? I'm just checking because I know we have I've got a colleague that has actually designed kind of PowerPoint and all those elements about what does it mean to be critical and all those kind of things. So that might be a good thing that we share that with you. Share across all the different units. So So the students really understand what we mean by being critical and that we are on the same page all over. That would help. I think once again is the main issue is really understanding what we mean by criticality, and that's what students tend to actually find difficult. Because of course, even if you are doing a really, really good job understanding something, describing something, you still miss this upper analysis that is, you know, once again answering the answer what question. Why do I need to know that? What are the implications? What is the impact? Why do I need to talk about that? And the part of reflectivity and criticality is a lot around that. And you know, that to be frank, that's something a lot of students are struggling with, not only at the master level, but most of my PhD students at the feedback they receive. And when they are actually, you know, doing their viva, is yeah, but where is your critical analysis? Where did you put that? So it's not easy. I think we can try to find some ways to actually achieve that.
As for my experience in Korea, whenever I look at those units, some of the units just, they upload only the unit and only the UIF, unit information form. There are no guided teaching or guided learning areas. That is also black.
Yeah.
Already black for our SPI in my university. But I have seen in other temples quite that for our SPI in my university, no nothing for us, only UIF in the MBA courses.
In the MBA courses?
Yeah. In hospital management. Yeah.
I think it's a technical problem. No, I think it's a technical problem because there are, the way Brio is working is that they are opening loads of different shell, even if it's not running. So if it's not running, it's left empty. But if it's running, if you don't have any content, that's where we have a problem. But I don't think that happened in a really, really long time. Most of the units, when they are running, you have the content, don't you? A gap of a block, you're not in sync with the other block. So when coordinators, unit coordinators usually upload, they upload for the whole, all partners, and you are just a little bit out of sync. I just have to make sure that we remind the unit coordinator that it's not the same planning and to make sure that they are really in line. Yeah, so MBA there is a rule, you are part-time students for the first assignment during week 6, the second assignment during week 12.
Yeah. Thank you.
So depending on when you are actually starting, then you count 6 weeks and 12. Okay, thanks a lot. I will see some of you this afternoon, I think. And good luck. Bye.
many rights here.
จะหมอป้าสวยจะแช่ดอกเหมือนเนรีเด็กพิ้วเนี่ยเลยได้ไหม